Hello everyone. Today I will show you how to use Codeanywhere to programming. So maybe you will ask what is Codeanywhere. Simply say Codeanywhere is an online code editor and it gives you a small free container. In other words, a small Linux computer so that you can put all your codes in it and deploy your programs. Since you was given a Linux computer, you can freely install any necessary programs or libraries. Thus, there is no limitation of what kind of language you want to program in. This is a huge advantage in compared to other online editors. But first, let's go to the Codeanywhere page. Code editor can be used for free. Just register it and log in, then click the editor button. You will launch to the editor. After first time launch to the editor, a window will pop up. It asks you what kind of connection you want to have. Let's close it and go to the left panel. Let me explain something here. You will see the three items: default, open files, and connections. The default is the project name which you are working on. Then the open files. Open files is all the files you edited will be listed here. The last one is the connections. Connections means where your codes come from. In most cases, it is a container or a small computer from Codeanywhere. So what we need to do at first, of course, is to create a container. Right-click the connections and select the new connection. A wizard window will pop up. Here, we can see a list of possible connections. Container simply means create a small Linux computer from Codeanywhere. GitHub, Bitbucket means get the code from your GitHub repository. After that, create a Codeanywhere container. Git from URL is the same like the previous choice, but they get the code from other Git repositories. FTP and SFTP means connect your remote server via FTP or SFTP so that you can also edit the codes on it. Dropbox, Google Drive, OneDrive, Amazon S3, DigitalOcean means you can also get the data from these services. Now, let's create a container. Call the name test flask. Now, let's choose a container. We want a Python container with Ubuntu. Yes, see here. Python Ubuntu 16.04. Create. Now we created a container. Wait several seconds. You will see here is test flask container, deploying container. That's our computer. Okay, it looks like finished. Yeah. Here is the information about our container. It has 2 GB disk storage and 256 MB. You have sudo write, SSH access here, and you can also deploy your web application from this address or this address. So let's take a look. Take a look at the SSH terminal. Yes, this is our container or our computer. Let's take a look. Python version. Yeah, we have Python 3.7, and it is under directory word workspace. Now we can begin to write some codes here. I will demonstrate with Python flask. Right click the container, test flask, and let's choose create a file. And give the name app.py. Okay. From flask import flask. Here you see we need the package flask. So we go to our console terminal, install this package. Use pip install flask. Okay. Now go back to app.py. This is our Flask basic code. Now we can go to. Now what we should do is let the computer run the Flask program. Go to configure. Here you see that's is all the command. The CW part is the working directory path. You can change it to other directory what you like. The commands part is the command which you use to start your program. In our example, it is flask run blah blah. The environment part is the setting of our environment value for our program. For example, where is your config file? Or where is your Flask app? Now, let's write our Flask run command in the commands part. You need to write something here. Flask run. You should give the host 0.0.0 and port. Please give here 3000. It is special for code anywhere so that you don't need to give extra port in your UI. It's very important. We should give here the Flask app. Flask app. Our Flask app is here. So save. Oh, invalid format. We should take care. A command should be one string. here we flask run, this is too many strings. Let's make them to be one string. Now we can save the config file and run the project. See, a browser popped up with our result page. The URL is this one. Test flask is the project name and Codeanywhere is the username. In the meanwhile, another console also popped up. It locked the flask output. Another useful tip is you can also let the container check your libraries every time before you run it. Simply just click a requirement.txt file here. And then write down all the necessary libraries, for example, flask. Or maybe you also need flask SQL, alchemy. Yeah. Then save it. Then you go to the config. I think it should be conf. Yep. Here you add the here already written something for you. Pip install minus r requirements.txt file. Okay, now we can run our project. Stop it at first and run the project. See? The logged out window show you the result of the installed libraries. That is what I want to show you. Thanks very much for watching. I hope this video can help you a little to begin with Codeanywhere. See you next time.